These are Tuco-Tucos, some of which are very social, while others prefer to go it alone. These small rodents are found in South America. Being social certainly has its benefits, sharing food, warmth, and protection. All the perks that this little Tuco-Tuco enjoys by living with others inside its burrow. This burrow is part of a huge underground network, spanning right across an open landscape in North Argentina. Tuco-Tucos spend most of their time moving about underground. Observing how they use the space around them can tell us a lot about their social behavior. For example, we know that they travel further during the day than at night and frequently visit the same places by sharing each other's underground burrows. They also mostly form the same groups during the day and at night. An interesting question is, why do some Tuco-Tucos choose to go it alone? Well, some Tuco-Tucos change the groups they associate with in the day and in the night, while others decide not to be part of a group at all and just be alone. These little creatures are described as being facultatively social, meaning that individuals within the species can make decisions to change their social behavior depending on their circumstances. It shows that this species has a powerful and flexible brain. We are yet to fully understand why these rodents choose to be social or antisocial. Animals are complex, and it may be that this Tuco-Tuco's motive for being alone is not that different to our own, as we change our social behavior to protect the lives of others.